السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, الحمد لله, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have entered into the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Very special nights, because within them is the night of Qadr, Laylatul Qadr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us, Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. The night of power, the night of Qadr, is better than 1,000 months. Better than 1,000 months. So it could be worth 1,001 months, it could be worth 2,000 or even 2 million or even more than that. The true knowledge of that is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So indeed, it is a mighty opportunity, it is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should be seeking to increase our worship in that night so that we are rewarded. Now, how do we achieve that? By worshipping and maximizing our worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every one of these 10 nights, because we are not sure, we have not been given the knowledge of when exactly that night falls. So it's important that we continue to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more vigorously in these last 10 nights, so it coincides with the night of Qadr. Five tips. Tip number one is to be sincere in whatever we do. Whatever acts of worship that we do sincerely for the pleasure and for the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to show off and not for any other motive. So for example, we fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning that we fast because Allah has legislated fasting upon us, and Allah is happy and is happy with this deed. Not for the reason of, for example, losing weight, or not for the reason of it is good for our diets. Whatever benefits fasting brings with it, that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that will occur. But our intention is that we understand it is a command of our Lord, it is prescribed by our Lord, and that's why we fast. So it's important that whatever we do, we have a sincere intention, because it's a condition for the acceptance of deeds. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, innamal a'malu binniyat, actions are rewarded in accordance with their intentions. Number two is to pray qiyam, that is to pray at night. Now, the night prayer, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us, man qama laylatul qadri imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Whosoever prays qiyam on laylatul qadr with conviction, with faith and due consideration, their past sins shall be forgiven. So indeed, a great opportunity to seize, a great opportunity to take on board, that we pray during the last 10 nights. So again, it coincides with Laylatul Qadr, and we are among the people the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in this hadith. Do not worry too much about the number of raqat that you pray. Do not make that the most important issue, whether you are praying 8 or whether you are praying 20. No, concentrate on the quality of the prayer. It may be that somebody's two raqat of night prayer is better than somebody's 20 raqat. So concentrate on the quality more than anything else and the intention behind it. Tip number three is to give in charity. Indeed, it is a great deed in Islam to give in charity. Give from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed us with. In a hadith, it is mentioned, Ya Ibn Adam, anfik, unfika alayk. O Ibn Adam, O son of Adam, spend and I shall spend, or you shall be spent upon. And this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will spend on you if you spend, then that is something great. That is something which is not to be ignored, not to be wasted. So give in every night of these last 10 nights. So again, it coincides with Laylatul Qadr. Tip number four is to connect with the Quran. And yes, I say connect rather than recite the Quran. Indeed, recitation of Quran is a mighty deed. However, we must understand, as I have mentioned in a previous video earlier on in this blessed month, that the main purpose of the Quran is to guide, is a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that message, for many of us, that if we don't understand the Arabic language, is not obtained through mere recitation. So the main way to connect with the Quran is trying to understand the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we may be guided, so that we may take heed from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So spend these last 10 nights in trying to learn the meanings of at least the surahs that you have memorized and that you recite in your salah, so that your salah becomes more meaningful and the Quran has a better effect upon you, and so that we have connected with the Quran in a better way. Indeed, trying to learn the meanings of the Quran is much better than just mere recitation without any reflection upon and ponderance upon the meanings of the Quran. Tip number 5 is to make plenty of dua continuously throughout the night. Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if I knew which night is Laylatul Qadr, what should I do? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam advised her to make dua, to say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. This is the dua many of us have memorized and many of us know, but this is the origins of that dua. It is something the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam advised Aisha radiallahu anha with. Indeed, this dua should be recited, you know, continuously in and during these last 10 nights. Recite this dua by raising your hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Recite this dua in your sajdas when you are most closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make it a common habit in these last 10 nights. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you and I. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us on the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us acceptance. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.